All right, so if you're using Google Sheets, and let's just say that we've created this spreadsheet and we're ready to share it with other people. Now, whether or not maybe we're done and we want to share with other people to see it, or maybe we just want some other people to be able to log into it and work alongside us, we'll go over those different permission levels to enable you to do that right now. And you start by going into the upper right-hand corner and left-clicking on the green rectangle that says Share. And if I do that, I get the sharing dialog that comes up. And you have two main options. You can share it with people in groups, or you can work with just getting a link. So for now, we're going to talk about what sharing it with people in groups means, and then later we'll go into getting a link. Let's just say that you created this spreadsheet and you know who you want to share it with. So it's a person named Michael, or you just type that in. And you get a drop down here showing your recent contacts and suggesting people who it thinks you might be talking about. I'm going to left click on the one that I do want to share it with. And for this particular person, and if I typed anyone else into this empty space and added them, you can select from three different levels of permissions. So these go from the least amount of permissions down to the most pervasive setting, which is editor. So if you just want them to be able to look at the spreadsheet and not change it, you would left click on viewer. If you wanted them to be able to use some commenting functions but not actually edit anything, make them a commenter, or you give them full privileges, which would be editor. So we'll just leave it at editor for now. And the second thing to keep in mind is this Michael, he's not going to know you shared this with him unless you notify him. Maybe he knows because you just talked to him, in which case you can just remove this check mark. But I'm going to put that check mark back in. I'm going to say, here's the spreadsheet we just talked about. Okay, and then I'm going to left click on send. This is going to send Michael an email, and it's also just going to show up in his Google Drive. So I'm going to take what I'm working on. I'm going to put it on the left-hand side of the screen. So this is the spreadsheet that we started with. And then I'm going to left click on this drive, and I have a different person logged in here. So if I left click on here, you can see this is the account of Michael. I'm going to take it, I'm going to move it onto the right hand side. So on the left is the original spreadsheet, and my account on the right is Michael. So if we go down in Google Drive to shared with me, this spreadsheet is going to show up now. He also would have received an email. If I had Gmail open, you would see it. But this is a spreadsheet, so I'll double left click on it to open it up. And because I gave Michael editing privileges, what you could do, Michael could go in here, so we'll look at 30938, change it to 411, it changes on the right-hand side and on the left-hand side. So you have full edit privileges with the way that we shared it right now. And we can see each other through these icons, and you can also chat with each other if you want to. So that's the most basic type of sharing, is just to share it with one other person. But let's look at some of the other types. So I'll left click on share again. And another option, see, it says share with people and groups. So you may have some groups, you may not, but I've set some up and I'll show you what that means. Let's maximize this window again. Let's get rid of the sharing dialog for now. Go to Google Drive, where we can go in the upper right hand corner and see these other Google apps. There's one called Groups, left click on that. And you can just see that I have two groups. So we're acting like this is a company. There's a marketing group and a production group. And these would have a predefined set of people in them. So if I go back to Google Sheets and I left click on Share and I say marketing, it'll bring up that group as an option. I left click on it, and this, I have the same options here to control the different levels of permissions. And this is a way that I can share this file with an entire group of people. So it can be a department at a company, or it can be a group of friends, whatever you want. We'll go ahead and send that one too. It's a popular file. And that mostly covers sharing with people in groups. We have a few more things to talk about here. If you left click on editor here, you can give temporary access. And you get a dialog where you can expire the access in 30 days, or you can just change that. And that's what it defaulted to. and you can specify when it will expire. If you don't see the ability to add that expiration, that's probably because you're not using a G Suite account. So if you want to have extra options, you want to use Google Apps inside of a company, check out the description. I can get you codes for 20% off your first year for G Suite through an affiliate program. You send me a message and I'll send you those codes back. And let's just close that dialogue for now and look at one more thing before we move on to sharing with a link. And that's this gear icon in the upper right hand corner. And after you have everything set up, you can choose whether or not the people that you gave editor permissions to can change other people's permissions, and whether or not viewers and commenters can download, print, and copy. All right, let's just leave those the way they are, and we'll go back. And that covers sharing with other people and groups. And so let's go down now to getting a link. This is the link that people can use to get to your spreadsheet, and you can just left click on copy link to get a copy of it. But you can control how this link behaves. So right now it is selected to just be restricted, which means only the people that you just added can open it with this link. So if you go up to look at who you added, if you want to give that link to the marketing group again, they'll say, hey, Adam, you know, how do we find this? And they don't know how to use Google Drive very well. You want to give them the link. It will still stay protected because only people that added can open it with that link. All right, but you do have other options here. There's three other options. One of them is anyone at your company. And again, this is a G Suite option. It won't be here if you're using a personal account, but if you are using G Suite, you left click on this, and then anyone at your company can view. And you have options to limit how they view it. Third option, which you will have in a personal account, is just anyone with a link. So now this fundamentally changes how your spreadsheet behaves on the internet because anyone that gets this link can view it. Now it is a long, pretty random link, so no one's going to be able to just guess that. But if someone gets a hold of it that you haven't specified can see the sheet, they'll be able to see the sheet. So just keep that in mind. And anyone with the link can be any one of these same three privilege categories. So you could put this on the internet and say anyone with the link can be an editor, but just be careful with how you share the link. That's all. So if we copy this link and we said anyone can use it, if we go up into Google Chrome and I open up a new window, but I opened up an incognito window, meaning the internet doesn't know who this is. This window is not logged into any Google account. If I put that link in here and I hit enter, it will still bring me to the spreadsheet. And instead of 1806, I can change this to 19 and it updates. So this is the Wild West. If you share this link with the wrong people, anyone can change it. Let's go back to my main account. And you'll know that someone else is in here because one, you shared it with Michael, and it knows who Michael is because he's logged into his Google account, so you see the M. But then you have someone here who just gets kind of a silly cartoon assigned to them. So the anonymous hippo, that's someone else that's in the spreadsheet, but Google doesn't know who they are. They're not logged in. So you can always see who's in the spreadsheet and using it up here in the upper right-hand corner. You can also see a few statistics, so you can see the viewers that you shared it with. You can see all the viewers. And if you've been sharing this for a while, you can see the trend of the viewers. This is what I just did while I was making this video. So this is a history of who I added and how I did it. So that can be helpful if you find that the spreadsheet is shared with someone you didn't mean to and you're wondering how it happened, you can look through here. And you can also turn off these settings if you don't want someone seeing who you shared it with. So let's hit cancel, back out of there. Close that. So that should cover all the basics for what you need to know to share your sheet. And if you want to automate some work in your spreadsheet, write some macros on how to do certain repetitive steps with one click, and check out this next video. Thanks.